Thank you. The next item of business is topical questions, and at question number one I call Liz Smith.
To ask the Scottish Government for what reason it has reportedly not allocated £450 million of available EU funding for investment projects in Scotland.
Cabinet Secretary Kate Forbes.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Well, I can say in this chamber that the allegation is simply wrong, because the programme is not yet complete. By the end of the programme, most of the funding will be spent, and the claims that other parts of the UK will achieve specific levels of spend are also wrong, because their schemes have not closed either. We do not expect Scotland to be markedly different from the level achieved in previous schemes.
Liz Smith.
Well, I'm interested, Deputy First Minister, in that response, and it's the same response that the First Minister provided, that EU funds will be spent by the SNP in the future, but according to EU data, the Scottish Government has already returned €199 million unspent euros from the fund, and reports are that it is struggling to spend the other €331 million. Does the Deputy First Minister understand just why local government, those who are running enterprise and investment programmes, and those who are running our cash-strapped public services, are so angry?
Cabinet Secretary.
Well, no, I don't, because Liz Smith's question fails to understand how this scheme operates. The scheme operates when the Scottish Government pays out funds at its own risk and then claims reimbursement from the European Commission. So the idea that the Scottish Government is sitting on lots of money which it will return completely fails to understand the way in which this scheme operates. Even when the scheme was in suspension, the Scottish Government was still paying money to partners. So there was no point in which partners were not able to claim the money from the Scottish Government, and then the Scottish Government claims reimbursement. The other point I would say is that Liz Smith obviously sits on the Finance Committee, so she will understand the way in terms of the way the outturn data works. There is no outturn data, and when that is published, it will be provided to the Finance Committee very shortly after it's provided to the Scottish Government. So there has been no conclusion to the scheme. The scheme will continue. We will try and endeavour to spend as much of it as possible. 60% of the allocations are being made to local government. The rest is allocated largely to non-departmental public bodies like Nature Scot and Skills Development Scotland. There are close relationships there. We will continue to provide that money to partners at our own risk and then claim the reimbursement from the European Commission, as these schemes have always operated for years.
Liz Smith.
Deputy First Minister, when you say you will try to spend the money, surely that money was available before, and therefore it should have been earmarked for spending that was going to help the Scottish budget. Now, the Finance Secretary said in her recent budget statement, and I quote, quite simply, we cannot spend money that we do not have. So does the Deputy First Minister actually agree with the Finance Secretary? Because you did have that money, and therefore it could have been spent on urgently required investment.
Cabinet Secretary.
It is being spent. We have until 2025 to continue to spend it. It is being spent currently. It will continue to be spent. There has been no point at which it is not being spent. We will continue to maximise the funding available. I have looked closely at the source of the figures that were reported. I've looked at the European Commission's open data portal. I cannot in any way, based on that data, arrive at the £450 million that quoted. The point here is that we are maximising the funding that's available. Liz Smith is in a party which is stripping all EU funding from Scottish communities. And so for as long as this scheme exists, we will maximise the funding available, and many thousands of people, businesses and communities in Scotland have already benefited and will continue to benefit until the scheme closes next year.
Kenneth Gibson.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. In October 2021, Michael Gove awarded £23.7 million in levelling up monies, a partial replacement for EU funding to upgrade the B714, a strategic necessity. 2 weeks ago, I met him to point out that neither the funds nor an inflationary increase to deliver the project, in common with 60 of 71 across the UK, have been delivered, and Mr Gove is now retired as an MP. Will the Scottish Government press an incoming government to honour levelling up commitments made to deliver on essential strategic projects the outgoing UK Government promised?
Cabinet Secretary.
Well, we will, of course, press an incoming UK government, whatever the party, to honour its levelling up commitments. But Mr Gibson says that levelling up was a partial replacement for EU funding. And neither parties that are most likely to form the next UK government in any way want to return us to being able to benefit from that EU funding.
Michael Mara.
Sir, Audit Scotland confirmed that access to these funds is available to the end of June 2024. According to the EU's Cohesion Open Data platform, the SNP have 27 days to spend €280 million. Even by their own standards of fiscal incompetence, this is chaos. The initial budget has already been reduced by €72 million due to, by their own admission, lack of demand or lack of ability to spend it. Can I ask the Deputy First Minister, if she doesn't recognise the €450 million figure, what is her figure in terms of the underspend? Also, were programmes fully matched by public bodies or were cuts made by this government multiplied? And will the government supply the full figures at the end of June?
Cabinet Secretary.
Well, I think the member, much like Liz Smith, fails to understand how the scheme works. The scheme works when partners receive money from the Scottish Government. The Scottish Government allocates the funding and then claims reimbursement. The risk entirely sits with the Scottish Government. This is not the case of grant funding coming to the Scottish Government and then it being allocated by the Scottish Government. And I would appeal to members across the chamber to understand how this scheme works. Secondly, the final expenditure figures will not be known until 2025. And yes, they will be published. In fact, they will be published openly and transparently, and they will reveal just how much money the Scottish people have benefited from by being associated with the European Union. And what they will also realise is how disappointing it is that no party likely to return to the UK government, including the Labour Party, will in any way restore that funding to the Scottish people.
Gordon MacDonald.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. It's welcome that the Deputy First Minister has confirmed that the Scottish Government's expectation is that most of that funding will be spent by the time these programmes conclude. Can the Deputy First Minister say any more about the projects these EU investment funds have supported in Scotland to date? And does she share my concern that the UK Government's replacement funding programmes fall far short of the EU funding lost to Scotland after Brexit?
Cabinet Secretary.
Well, I think that last point is indisputable. But yes, there have been hundreds of projects across Scotland that have been supported in the last programme of European structural funds. And if we go all the way back to when they started in 1973, because that's how long there has been benefit flowing to the Scottish people, you see thousands of programmes. In the Highlands, new enterprise hubs like the Rural and Veterinary Innovation Centre, supporting children with foundation, modern and graduate apprenticeships. In terms of our climate change objectives, electric vehicle charging points and active travel schemes, and in terms of business, free advice and support for businesses and SMEs across Scotland. I hope that the Chamber can unite in recognising just how critical these funds have been, not just to my constituents, but right across Scotland. And it remains a matter of sadness that UK Government replacement funding, like the Shared Prosperity Fund and the Levelling Up Fund, is not like-for-like replacement.
Thank you. Question number two, Martin Whitfield.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. To ask the Scottish Government whether it remains its position to have a target of 60% of household waste recycled annually by 2020, in light of reports that the target is being dropped.
Cabinet Secretary Mary McCallum.
Presiding Officer, first of all, allow me to say that Scotland recycled 62.3% of all waste in 2022, which is the most recent year reported on. This is the highest level since records began. Next, I want to be absolutely clear and to reassure Mr Whitfield that we are not dropping targets. Reports to the contrary are inaccurate. The Circular Economy Bill, currently passing through Parliament, together with the draft Circular Economy and Waste Routemap, they set out measures that we intend to take to improve and to modernise local recycling services and drive up reuse and recycling rates. This includes a commitment, which is in line with advice from the Committee on Climate Change, to set new circular economy targets from 2025 so they are future-proofed, so that they support our work to tackle the climate emergency, and so that they can help us measure progress in reducing emissions.
Martin Whitfield.
I thank the Cabinet Secretary for that response, and I'm glad that we are not dropping targets. But in face of the unknowns, like the moving targets, the deposit return schemes, the circular economy bills, adding instability to the industry, how is the government going to support our local authorities who sit at the forefront of delivering household waste recycling to increase the recycling levels?
Cabinet Secretary.
Very pleased to take that question head on, Presiding Officer, because it's a very important one, co-designing our approach to improving reuse and recycling with local authorities, as well as with business and with communities, has been absolutely central to the approach that the government has taken. That has been backed up, of course, by funding support. That £70 million Recycling Improvement Fund has already supported 25 councils to reduce waste and to increase their recycling rates. Now the bill and the route map set out new powers, including working with local authorities and households, to design new statutory standards for recycling across Scotland, and we will continue to work with partners in pursuit of that.
Martin Whitfield.
I'm very grateful. One of the concerns was, of course, that we were talking about targets that were going to be hit in 2020. And national household recycling rates in Scotland have flatlined for a decade. Wales, in contrast, has made steady progress and has raised household recycling itself to a national average of 65%. Their target is 70% by next year, and this is expected to be met. So where is the Scottish Government's ambition? Where is its drive? Where is the sight to see that we can raise our recycling, which will answer problems with regard to the climate, problems with regard to the economy, and for once do the right thing?
Cabinet Secretary.
Well, the ambition, Presiding Officer, is there in the draft route map. It is there in the bill, which is currently passing through Parliament, and it is there in the funding that's in place to support all of these interventions, that £70 million Recycling Improvement Fund that I mentioned. Ultimately, Presiding Officer, the overall recycling rate in Scotland is at its highest since reporting began in 2011. But we recognised that much has changed since then, not least the confirmation of a climate emergency, and our targets should be updated. They should be updated in respect of separate waste streams. They should be updated in respect of carbon accounting. That's per advice from the Committee on Climate Change, and I'm very pleased with the consensus that has dominated the passage of the Circular Economy Bill, and I hope it continues.
Thank you. Maurice Golden.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. The Minister, Cabinet Secretary, mentioned carbon metric. The Scottish Government intends to use the carbon metric to assess recycling performance for Scotland. This is an extract from the Scottish Government's carbon metric guidance on the 15th of March 2011. What have the Scottish Government been doing for the last 13 years?
Cabinet Secretary.
Well, I'm very happy to set out a lot of the progress that we have made against our targets for improving reuse and recycling in Scotland. The overall recycling rate, as I've said, is 62.3% in 2022, the highest since reporting began. The overall official statistics show that we now landfill less than a quarter of all waste at 23%, the lowest level on record. The total amount of waste going to landfill in Scotland has nearly halved over the past decade, and we've also now met our target to reduce total waste arising in Scotland by 15% against 2011 levels for 2 years in a row. And to top all that off, Presiding Officer, in 2021 the waste sector carbon emissions were 76% lower than in the 1990 baseline. I can recognise that as progress. I hope Maurice Golden can as well.
Bill Kidd.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. The Scottish Government has been ambitious in its plans for a circular economy, and having taken action on problematic items to help tackle throwaway culture and already introducing a ban on many single-use plastic items, including most recently action to ban disposable vapes. Clearly, the pandemic impacted household recycling rates. And can the Cabinet Secretary then detail how the Circular Economy Bill will help us meet our ambitions?
Cabinet Secretary.
Presiding Officer, I think it is clear in Mr Kidd's contribution and in those from others across the Chamber that we have to make the circular option the easiest for Scottish households and our communities, and that the Government and local authorities must work together in pursuit of this. That's why the Circular Economy Bill gives ministers and local authorities the tools that we need to help Scotland achieve that transition. It will support local authorities, businesses and householders to co-design recycling services to create more consistency across Scotland. And there are a number of examples of other interventions that the bill takes, not least providing powers for charges for specific throwaway single-use items and restrictions on the disposal of unsold goods.
Sarah Boyack.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. Given the importance of reducing waste in our communities, and as the Cabinet Secretary said, tackling our climate emergency, doesn't it mean that we need to see the Scottish Government redouble its efforts to support our councils as they co-design to deliver on the new targets that will be coming next year, especially given the fact that our Welsh local authorities received £1 billion over the last decade, and that's why they are now world leading in terms of delivering on reducing waste in their communities?
Cabinet Secretary.
Presiding Officer, I absolutely accept the premise of Sarah Boyack's point that funding behind ambitious proposals from the Government is essential. That's why I again point to that £70 million Recycling Improvement Fund, which, as I said in response to an earlier question, has already supported 25 councils across Scotland to reduce waste and to increase recycling rates. And it's why I've also given a commitment, an ongoing commitment, to very close working between Scottish Government and our local authority partners on the implementation of what is a very ambitious piece of legislation.
And Liam MacArthur.
Thank you. A ban on biodegradable municipal waste entering landfill is planned from 2025, yet a government commissioned report has confirmed Scotland won't have the capacity needed to manage the waste without landfilling. Former Minister Lorna Slater repeatedly refused to answer the question, so can the Cabinet Secretary now say whether she expects Scottish waste to be exported for landfill in England when the ban comes into place next year?
Cabinet Secretary.
Presiding Officer, the point is well made by Liam MacArthur. First of all, it's important to point out that in the last decade, and that's 2012 to 2022, the amount of waste sent to landfill in Scotland has nearly halved, and that has been pursued alongside changes that we've sought to make in incineration, and the balance there has to be managed very carefully. On the specific point that Liam MacArthur raises, I know that the Minister, Gillian Martin, is considering it carefully. I know that she's also engaging with colleagues across Chamber as we move to Stage 3 of the Circular Economy Bill, and I will ask that she engages on Liam MacArthur on that point if she has not done so already.
Thank you. That concludes topical questions. There will be a short pause before we move on to the next item of business.